Hello kids, welcome to the session at Learn Forward platform by Feathercap. So I'm your English facilitator Garima Singh to make your learning easy and fun. Let's begin. Hope you are ready with your book Fly High Grade 3. Today we'll be reading chapter 3 that says Brain Boss. We all know that all the activities, they are controlled by brain, right? So brain is the boss, it is the main organ of our body. So we'll be reading a poem about brain, which is very important part of our body. Let's read the poem to know about our brain. So before we start the poem, we have a small activity. We have, we have the organs and then their functions we need to match. So with the help of teeth, what do? We bite. Legs, they help us to run. Ears, with the help of ears, we listen to the music and, you know, everything. Arms, they help us to carry. So next, let's start with the poem. I've never seen you, we have never met. I cannot hear or touch you, and yet you are there in my head, a part of me. So the poet says that I have never seen you, we have never met each other, nor I have touched you, and still you are there in my head. You know, you are with me all the times, you are there in my head, and you are an important part of me, helping me touch and hear and see. So the poet says that, you know, the brain, it helps you in doing everything. You know, the message first goes through the brain and then the activity is conducted. So he says that you are the one who helps me in hearing, in touching and seeing. Okay, you wiggle my fingers and lift my feet. Wiggle means, you know, to move your fingers up and down. So you are the one who helps me in wiggling my fingers and lifting my feet, and open my mouth when I want to eat. You must have noticed that, you know, if there is something, suppose you are walking and something immediately you find a stone. So, you know, you do not step onto it. Your brain, it gives you the message to, you know, keep your feet away, do not step onto it. So everything, all the messages are sent by the brain to the different parts of the body. So he says that, you know, when I want to eat, you are the one who instructs my mouth to open so that I can put food inside. You make me happy and sad and cross. So he says that it is you who makes me feel happy and you are the one who makes me feel sad. There's no doubt about it, you are the boss. So he says that, you know, there is no doubt at all because you are controlling everything. So you are the boss. Because see, you know, the boss, like if we have the principal, if we talk about the principals we have in school, they are the one who controls everything. They are the ones who advises, who guides and who instructs, and then the further processing is being done. You summon my laughter, send out my scream. Summon means order someone or something to come to you. So you are the one, you know, who orders smile and then, you know, the smile comes on my face, and then you are the one who gives the order or the command to for me to shout and scream. Think all my thoughts and dream all my dreams. So, you know, you are the one who helps me in thinking, you know, whatever is going in my mind, you know, whatever I'm thinking. And you are the one who knows my dream and you live all my dreams. And I can't keep count of the number of times. So, you know, the poet says that I cannot count the number of times you help me in giving the rhythms and rhymes. Rhythms is a strong, regular, repeated pattern of movement or a sound, right? And rhymes, we all know, a word that has the same sound as another. We have the rhyming word. So he says that you are the one who, you know, helps me, who gives me so many rhythms, and you help me in creating so many rhymes. So I'm writing this poem Brain for you, though I wonder now if that's really true. Now he says that, you know, this poem is dedicated to you, Brain, and, you know, I wonder that if it is really you or somebody else. The more I think, the more I see. That's, it's you who are writing the poem for me. So he says, the more I think, you know, the more I think, I'm able to put down in I'm going able to put down my thoughts on paper, and then I can create poems. So he says that brain, you are the boss, you control everything, and it is in your hands. Whatever we do is a command given by you. So it was really a nice poem. Now let's come to the exercise. Which of the following means the same as confusion? So confusion means doubt, correct? Which word is correctly spelled? So which is the correct spelling of summon? S-U-M-M-O-N. Let's just cross check. Yes, S-U-M-M-O-N. Next we have the extract, and based on it we need to answer the questions. What is the poet talking about? So what is the poet talking about? The poet is talking about the most important part of the body, that is the human brain. According to the poet, what cannot be touched or heard? So he says that the brain can neither be touched nor we can hear it, but then still it is there inside the head all the times with us. You are there in my head. Write the rhyming words for the following. Yet, met, see, me. So the rhyming words are the words, the set of words that have the same sound with different spelling and different meanings. Alright, the next we have the true false. We have never seen our brain. Have we seen the brain? No. We've just seen it in the pictures or in the images. True. We cannot touch our brain. Absolutely correct. Brain helps us to touch, hear and see. Yes. Brain does not make us happy. Brain is the one who makes us happy, who makes us feel sad. So, false. Next. Question answers, for whom is the poet writing the poem? The poem, the poet is addressing the brain in this poem and talking all about its functions, where all it has control and what all it helps us to do. What are the qualities of the poem that the brain helps to write countless times? The qualities of the poem that the brain helps to count, helps to write countless times are the rhythms and the rhymes. What does the brain summon about? The brain summons about the laughter and sends out the screams. Okay, so read the poem once again, go through the exercise, complete your work. See you tomorrow. Till then, take care. Happy learning.